everyone, thanks for joining. In this short video, I wanted to give you a summary and a quick run through of the key outtakes from the Devlin conference. As one of the speakers rightly said, if you want to really predict how will technology affect the learning in the future, you need to look how technology is affecting how people live now. You know, looking at things like Pokemon Go and how popular it was with everyone, especially the younger generation, how you know, Internet of Things is affecting pretty much everything that you buy now, from the light bulb to, you know, a smart fridge and telly, to the things like how hardware is getting cheaper and easier to acquire, so anyone could have access to it. It is predicted that by 2021 we'll have 18 billion connected devices. That means that not only you're watching your phone and you know your laptop will be connected to the internet, but everything, literally everything around you, will be. Which might have capability of actually hosting your personal assistant within that. Like Alexa, for example. So one of the things that we discussed in the Devlin conference was Internet of Things and how Alexa could actually help us to deliver learning to the individual. For example, would Alexa deliver IPA mandatory qualifications to learners in our industry, like the commercial certificate in Negrex? Does that mean that you can ask Alexa to tell me more about how regulations work in the UK, for example? Another thing, obviously very, very popular, was augmented reality that I had a whole video on. It's about overlaying the real world with a digital assets overlay. I don't really see that being used within the e-learning, as the learner is already engaged. He's looking at the learning already, either on the screen, the laptop, or on the mobile phone. So I don't see the augmented reality being used in that sense. But what I'm suspecting that we're going to see more and more of is some sort of more innovative ways of delivering induction programs, maybe icebreaker exercises and things like that. Virtual reality was another hot topic. It is very expensive to develop, because not only software developers need to be involved, designers, but also database developers, as there's quite a lot of work. But the cheaper it becomes, the more people get VR headsets at home, the easier it will become to deliver different learnings. Again, one of the examples I gave you in one of my other videos were delivering presentations, a skills course via VR headset. And I think that would be the best application for virtual reality. Again, I'm not really too confident that we would use VR within the e-learning, but you know, possibilities are endless. Possibly we could use it to maybe to put a person in some sort of situation where they have to give good or bad feedback for a creative work, for example. That's what we have in the IPA Foundation certificate. So that would be quite nice. They would imagine sitting in the meeting room with the creative director, or you know, creative team who are presenting their work to them. Another, probably the most important thing for me personally, and the most exciting thing, is artificial intelligence, of course. It is already affecting us, you know. It's becoming easier and easier for us to access certain things just because of the machine learning. It has quite a lot of potential for both e-learning and classroom style learning, I feel, where you could have, for example, assessments marked instantly. We could check if people are cheating very easily, but also just giving that instant feedback for the individual. As you know, more and more people, especially millennials, are really they're expecting this instant feedback. That would help with it, especially. Also having the virtual virtual coach who could guide you through the learning, who could, you know, give you some tips how to progress through your program, as well as adapting the learning to the individual. Again, as I said in my other one of the other videos, it would be quite nice that if you know the learning adapts to not only to your knowledge, to have some background on you, but the way you learn, so you the best, you get the best outtakes possible. And that's it, the key things where augmented reality, artificial intelligence and virtual reality all connected with through Internet of Things, all connected to the you know, how much data we'll soon have on everyone. It's very exciting times. I will be presenting at the IPA Training Forum, which is basically an informal gathering for people in learning and development and HR roles at the IPA next year, 2018. So if you wish to come, do let me know. I'll give you more details about that. But thank you so much for your time, and see you later.